Good morning one and all, welcome to my channel. My today's video is on lesson number 4, Louis Pasteur, Conqueror of Disease, written by E.H. Carter. Louis Pasteur, Conqueror of Disease. The author of this lesson is E.H. Carter. Before I start this lesson, I would like to discuss and mention few words like bacteria, lily, yeast, spontaneous generation, pasteurization, and so on. What do you mean by bacteria? Bacteria are vegetable organisms, that is, little rod-shaped plants which exist in water, air, soil and in the bodies of plants and animals. Men of science call germs as bacteria, a Greek word meaning little rods. Lille is a busy manufacturing town in France. There are many industries here. It's a manufacturing town mentioned in the lesson. Yeast. Yeast is a type of fungus or a tiny plant which is used to produce alcohol and also to make bread soft. It is made up of tiny living cells. Yeast is made up of tiny, small living cells. What do I mean by spontaneous generation? Spontaneous means all of a sudden. Here in this lesson, spontaneous generation means germs had no parents, but they just occurred by themselves. To mention this, they have used the word spontaneous generation. What do you mean by pasteurization? Pasteurization is a process wherein any liquid, maybe milk, maybe wine, it is heated up to a temperature of 50 to 60 degrees centigrade. And the germs, by heating it to this temperature, the germs are made harmless. Whenever you boil the milk, heat the milk, boil the milk, cool it and then keep it, it remains for a longer time. So this process is called pasteurization. It was found by Louis Pasteur. Bacteriology, it is a branch of biology that deals with the study of bacteria. What do you mean by inoculation? Inoculation means to treat a person or an animal against some disease by injecting a weak form of same disease germ into the body. What we do, we take a weak form of the germ and we inject it in the body of the person or the animal. And whenever the person is actually affected by that particular disease, then he will have the immunity. So that was inoculation. Inoculation means to treat a person or animal against some disease by injecting a weak form of the germs of the same disease into his body. What is vaccination? Vaccination is an injection or a medicine given to prevent a particular type of disease. We have a typhoid vaccine. What is immune? Immune means which cannot be harmed by a disease either because of the protective treatment or through one's body's natural resistance. The body has its own natural resistance, our body. For example, our body has some resistance, that is natural resistance. So immune means which cannot be harmed by a disease either because of the protective treatment or through body's natural resistance. What do you mean by anthrax? Anthrax, actually it was a disease which attacked the cows and the sheep in France. Anthrax, it is a disease which attacks the cow, sheep, goat, such animals. It first happened to occur in France. Rabies, a dangerous disease caused by mad dog bite. It's a dangerous disease caused by the bite of mad dog. So these are few new words in the lesson. You have to know the meaning of these words. You have to know what the word actually means. What is inoculation? What is vaccination? What is a germ? Then you will understand the lesson better. That is why first I discussed all these words. Coming to the explanation, the author E.H. Carter has introduced Louis Pasteur to the readers as a fighter. He says, Louis Pasteur is a fighter. He said he was fighting against diseases. However, he was the son of a brave soldier. Louis Pasteur was the son of a brave soldier who fought in the battlefield. Louis Pasteur fought against the germs. His father fought against in the battlefield, against the enemies. Louis Pasteur had a brother named Waterloo. Louis Pasteur devoted his whole life to the study of germs, which men of science call bacteria. Yes, bacteria are vegetable organisms, little rod-shaped plants which exist in air, water and soil in the bodies of animals and plants. However, bacteria are both harmful and useful. Some bacteria help in converting matter into food for the plants. Louis Pasteur had a busy and interesting life. He not only made discoveries about germs, but also he used to make discoveries in very practical ways. He worked in his laboratories with the test tubes and made all kinds of experiments. He worked for the people who were suffering from one or the other disease. He just wanted to find out what was the reason for that disease, which germs caused that disease. So he was busy in experimenting these things. Louis Pasteur helped the breeders, the breeders of silkworms, the cow keepers and the other traders in France. He was very proud of helping his country in this way. When he used to help the people, it means that he is helping the country. So he was very proud of himself when he helped his own country in this way. Louis Pasteur was born in a small town of France. As a young boy, he was interested in chemistry. He became a professor of chemistry, later got married to Marie, who was his close companion and assistant. So he got to Marie Pasteur. He got married to Marie Pasteur. She was the best companion for him and she was an assistant to him. Pasteur was interested in all the new experiments. He used to sit hours together, quite silent and motionless, thinking hard about the difficulties he would face. Whenever he used to face any difficulty, what he used to do? He used to sit in the laboratory and think hours together, quietly, motionless. Then, whenever he found a solution, what he would do? He would feel very happy. The kind, tired-looking face would brighten up. He would run to his wife to tell her about his success. Later, Louis Pasteur was appointed as head of the College of Science in Lille. Lille, as you know, it was a busy manufacturing town in France. Louis Pasteur was happy because he could help many traders, manufacturers, industrialists, because Lille was a manufacturing town. He began to give lectures on fermentation. One of the chief industries in Lille was the manufacturer of alcohol. That was the chief industry, manufacturing of the alcohol from beetroot. So one of the manufacturers came to Louis Pasteur and spoke to Louis Pasteur about his problem. He said, that his beer, the beer which is prepared from the beetroot, was turning bad. So at this time, Louis Pasteur discovered what is called as yeast. Louis Pasteur said, yeast is made up of tiny living cells. It is used to make the beer foam and bread rise. For this purpose, yeast is used. When the yeast was healthy, it acted well. But when it was diseased, the beer went wrong. The beer which they prepared from the beetroot, it went wrong. After a few years, Louis Pasteur, as the head of the College of Science, he was made the director of scientific studies. He was made the director of scientific studies in a famous college in Paris. So he was promoted now. He became the director of scientific science. Here, through his experiments, Louis Pasteur proved that germs were carried in air and they infected other things that came in contact with them. He proved this through his bent, narrow neck bottle and soup experiment. So what did he do? He put some soup into some bottles, boiled it in order to destroy the germs which were present in the soup. If any present in the soup, he boiled so that the germs would die. He then heated and pulled out the neck of each bottle until it formed a long narrow neck with a big bend in the middle. The soup remained there for a long time and never went bad. Pasteur said that there were no parent germs in the soup, and because of the long bent tube, the germs from outside could not enter and spoil the soup. He now spilt some soup in the bent. So he spilt the soup here and there. After a few days, he observed that the soup went bad. This was because of the dust trap, he said. The split soup carried the germs, settled there, and what they did? They infected the soup. So this is how Louis Pasteur proved that dust particles present in the air carry germs. This was his experiment, and finally he came to a conclusion. There was one more experiment which Louis Pasteur conducted. He wanted to prove about the pure and the stale air, where the soup would get spoilt, whether in the pure air or whether in the stale air. Louis Pasteur also carried on this experiment with soup bottles. He kept one soup bottle in a little hotel room where air hardly got exchanged. He broke the neck of the bottle, allowed the air to enter, and later on what he did? He sealed the bottle again. He took some more bottles in the field nearby and he did the same thing. And a few bottles he took and he kept it on the high mountain top. He kept it on the high mountain top. After a few days, he observed the bottles. The soup bottle which he kept in the hotel room had completely gone bad and moldy. It had completely gone bad and moldy. The bottles which were kept in the field were moldy, but not very bad. The ones which he kept on the mountain top had no germs at all. They did not have any germ. Thus he proved that pure air contains no germs. Stale air or dusty air contains the germs, and it is this that spoils the soup, or that spoiled any food item, that is likely to spoil any food item. Dusty air, stale air. If you keep something in the fresh air, it will not get spoiled. Louis Pasteur's another discovery was pasteurization, which means to make the germs harmless. How? By heating maybe milk, maybe wine, maybe any liquid, to a temperature of 50 to 60 degrees centigrade, cooling it. When we heat any liquid to a temperature of 50 to 60 degrees centigrade and cool it, that process will be called as pasteurization. It helps the liquid to remain in a better condition for a longer time. Louis Pasteur is called an all-round scientist. His research was for his fellow human beings. We can never imagine Louis Pasteur with explosives, with a poisonous gas. No, he is never with the explosives or poisonous gas. He is always with the disease-causing germs. He is always for those things which bring good to humanity, which bring good to mankind. Louis Pasteur also found one branch called bacteriology, that is the study of bacteria. He spent his time in tracking down the cause of the disease which ruined the silkworm industry. It had ruined. What was that germ that was causing the particular disease? Louis Pasteur was trying to discover a cure for anthrax. Anthrax is a disease which men get from infected shaving brushes and which was attacking the cows, the sheep in France and killing them off very quickly. He found that a cow could not have anthrax twice. A cow could not have anthrax twice. And he wondered why this cow never got anthrax the second time. He conducted some experiment on this. He carried out an experiment on some sheep, goat, cows. He collected them. He divided them into two lots. So one lot he injected with weak germs, with weak anthrax germs. One lot he injected them with the weak anthrax germs. And the other lot he left them all alone. The next day he took strong anthrax germs and he injected in both the lots, in this lot and the second lot. In both the lots he injected. Deadly anthrax germs were taken, injected in the first lot, injected in the second lot. After that, he observed the third day that the first lot, which was first given weak germs and then deadly anthrax germs, the first lot were perfectly okay. The animals of the first lot were perfectly okay. But the animals of the second lot, wherein only deadly anthrax germs were injected, those animals began to die one by one. So, this study of his, this experiment of his, made him discover what is called as inoculation. What is inoculation? A small quantity of weaker germs of a disease, any disease-causing germ, weaker germs of are taken, injected into a person's body. It helps the person develop immunity, and when the person actually suffers from deadly disease, he is having the immunity, he will not be affected by those deadly germs. Louis Pasteur was honored by the French government. His last experiment was in the connection with the terrible disease called rabies. Rabies is a disease which is got by the bite of a mad dog. He made his experiment on a young Alsatian boy who came to him in Paris with the bites of mad dog. The boy's mother asked Louis Pasteur to cure her son. She said, "If you can cure animals, you can cure my son." So Louis Pasteur inoculated him with some weak rabies germs, and the boy recovered. There is one institute opened in Paris in the name of Louis Pasteur. At the opening of the institute in 1888, Louis Pasteur said, "Two opposing laws seem to me in contest." It was Louis Pasteur's words. He said, "Two opposing laws seem to me now in contest." He said, "One law is a law of blood and death. Law of blood and death. The second law is a law of peace." So these were the two laws which he could clearly see. But science always obeys law of humanity. Louis Pasteur's looks of the old age are mentioned in the lesson. They have described how Louis Pasteur looked in his old age. He had deep lines on his face. The skin and the beard both were white. His hair still thick. He always wore a cap. He had a broad forehead, wrinkled, marked with lines of genius. Mouth slightly drawn because of paralysis. But his face looked full of kindness. Kindness overflowed. His 70th birthday was celebrated like a national festival. He was honored by the scientists of all the nations. His speech was read out to the audience by his son in the Great Hall of University of Paris. In his speech, he had written, "The future," he said, "will belong to those who shall have done most for the suffering." What suffering? Suffering the humanity. To the young students, he addressed a special word. First, ask yourselves, what have I done for my education? First, ask yourselves, what have I done for my education? Then, as you advance, you ask yourself, what have I done for my country? So that someday you will have the supreme happiness. You have done something to mankind. That supreme happiness will come to you. Pasteur died in the year 1895 when he was 75 years old. He was one of the greatest scientists that lived. So this is the lesson, Louis Pasteur, conqueror of disease. Hope you have understood, children. Coming to the examination point of view, questions like, Louis Pasteur was not a soldier but a fighter, explain, may be asked. Questions of this sort may be asked. Or questions like, what are bacteria? How did Pasteur solve the difficult problems? How did Louis Pasteur react when he solved the problem? His reactions when he could, when he was thinking about the difficult problems and when he actually got a solution for it. Then what discoveries did he make about yeast? What does spontaneous regeneration mean? What is vaccination? What is inoculation? What is pasteurization? What is anthrax? What is rabies? So these are all the short questions which are asked. Why were the scientists angry? The scientists were angry because they thought this Louis Pasteur is injecting germs in the body of a person. That is why they were angry. They were against it. The big questions may be like, explain the soup experiment to prove that fresh air contained no germs. Dust carries germs. Prove an experiment to show that dust carried germs. Or there may be reference to context asked. If you can cure animals, you can cure my son. What have I done for my country? These are the reference to context usually asked. And question may be like, what was troubling the French wine growers? The French wine growers, their beer, whatever wine they were preparing, that was going bad. So that was the that was troubling the French wine growers. What are the contributions of Louis Pasteur? Lengthy answer for 4 marks. You have tried all the contributions of Louis Pasteur. All researchers he did in laboratories were meant for his fellow human beings. Explain. Whatever experiment he carried on was mainly for his fellow human beings. It was for mankind. It was for humanity. So we have to explain all that. Which are the 2 laws of Louis Pasteur? So this is all about the lesson, Louis Pasteur, Conqueror of the Diseases, which is written by E.H. Carter. And I have told you examination point of view what is important. Hope you all have understood, children. Now it's time for me to tell, if you have liked it, what you have to do? You have to like, share, subscribe. Your comments are always welcome. Thank you.